Hello and welcome back to my garage. And today's video, my brother's car is back, or is still here in the shop. If you have seen the other videos, then you know that I did the brake caliper on the back, also the multi-belt, separate team belt, multi-belt, and I also give it a quick oil change. This is a bit of a add-on video for the particle filter sensor that we did replace a couple of years ago. Back then I also did a clean of a, yeah, they call it a DPF cleaner or particle filter cleaner. I also did it back then, but for some reason I did forget to, well, film that. So that's what we're going to do now. I will show you how to use one of these products. This is a product from a Dutch company called Motip. I do have some good and some bad experience with them. I don't like their paint stuff that much, but their technical sprays like cutting fluid and, well, stuff like this works pretty well. At least that is my experience with them. Of course, the method of how to use is probably not that different from other brands, but you definitely need to follow the instructions on the package of the stuff you used. And now I'm already breaking the rule. Why? Well, they advise you to unhook the sensor, you know, that particle sensor, and shoot this stuff into the hoses. But like you have seen, it is absolute nightmare to get to it, and I'm definitely not going to try to unhook those hoses again. So what I'm going to do is I am going to remove the O2 sensor. That's why I have that tool right here. That is definitely a must have. Get yourself one of these. So we're going to shoot it into the hole where the O2 sensor is located, or the lambda sonde. Other than that, be sure that the engine is cool. The car spent here overnight, so the engine is definitely cool. And other than that, what they advise you to do is give it a couple of quick sprays, 3 to 5 times. Well, at least on a package. So you spray it 3 or 5 times, just short bursts. Then let it sit for 5 seconds. And then you repeat that until the can is empty. So you have to dump the whole can into the particle filter. So that is what I'm going to do. These are the instructions that I have here on the can. If your can says something else, please do that. Of course, you want to use the O2 sensor that is on top of the particle filter and not at the bottom, if you have those, because, well, then it definitely not going through the filter, and you definitely want it going through the filter. So be sure, if you find somewhere a hole, if it is a EGT sensor location, a O2 sensor location, and like they say here on the can, into the hose of the sensor itself, the particle sensor itself, just be sure that you want to go through the filter. So that's enough said, let's get that thing clean. Well, the O2 sensor is located right here. So what I did is unplug the plug, and now it's just a matter of getting that thing out of there. These things can be really tight. Never trust these things around. These are really delicate. So don't hit them with some chemicals or something like that. Just wipe them off, do nothing crazy, and lay them to the side. So let's take it as far as we can get it. And it is something like here. So now, like it said on the package, short bursts, 3 or 5 times, and then let it sit for 5 seconds and rinse and repeat. One, two, three, four, five. Well, this is also a lie. 360 movement, well, almost not spraying at all. Well, let's get the last stuff in there. And then we can pull it out. And of course we have to screw back the O2 sensor. Plug in the plug. So now we need to start the car, let it sit for 15 minutes and then take it for a drive for half an hour. Don't be alarmed when you see white smoke, that's pretty normal. That is of course the fluid that is evaporating, so don't be alarmed by that. And there you have it, how to, clean your DPF filter or particle filter. Is this a repair? Well, to be honest, I've never seen a mechanic in a bottle. In this case, it's more of a preventive measure. And I do think it's a good thing to do every time you do a oil change. Would I try this when a particle filter is clogged? Absolutely. Absolutely, I would use this first before even replacing the particle filter itself. It did work on my brother's car. This of course is a lot cheaper than replacing the particle filter and also a lot less work. So why not try it at least? These cans are not that expensive. I do believe something like 15 euros, something like that. And maybe it does help removing some errors in your system. But basically, this is just a cleaning solution. But at least now you know how to do this. So if you are going to do the O2 route like I did, get yourself one of these O2 sockets or sensor sockets. And these are 22 millimeters, I believe. Yeah, 22 millimeters. It definitely makes your life a lot easier. But other than that, yeah, it's easy enough. But that's it for today's video. Hopefully you enjoyed it or at least learned something from it. And if you did, please give the like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do. And I will see you next time. Bye.